Hello and welcome to Green Scene. I'm Anesta Jones of the Office of Public Affairs. Green chemistry encourages innovation and promotes products that are both environmentally and economically sustainable. To tell us more about green chemistry, the benefits, and how you can get involved is Rich Engler of EPA's Office of Pollution Prevention and Toxics. Welcome to the show, Rich.
Well, it's a real pleasure to be here. Thank you.
There's such variation on green chemistry. What exactly is it in layman's terms?
Well, in a nutshell, green chemistry is cleaner, cheaper, smarter chemistry. It's pollution prevention at the molecular level. The design of environmentally preferable products and processes can reduce waste, eliminate costly end-of-pipe treatment, lead to safer products, and save resources such as energy and water. And these things benefit everybody. They benefit the companies, they benefit workers, the general public, and the environment.
And how does it differ from traditional methods to reduce pollution? Is it cheaper, for instance?
Well, in traditional chemistry, you would mix your ingredients together and isolate your product. But you might use a dangerous process, you might make hazardous waste, or the product that you're making might actually be hazardous. And anytime you have those sorts of hazards, you need to manage exposures to them. So, for instance, you might need worker protections or waste treatment. With green chemistry, hazard is considered upfront during the design, and you look to use less hazardous ingredients, make safer products, and make a lot less waste. Of course, that means it's a lot cheaper as well. You can make your materials much more efficiently and save money on the back end without that end of pipe treatments.
Let's talk about EPA's involvement. How does the agency promote and support green chemistry?
Well, we have a number of activities that promote green chemistry. We do outreach. We'll go out and speak at scientific meetings, trade associations, at universities and companies. We'll also enter into partnerships with organizations such as the American Chemical Society to develop educational materials so that the next generation of chemists have the tools that they need to develop or to be green chemists. We've also got recognition, and we have an awards program called the Presidential Green Chemistry Challenge Awards. And this prestigious award is a voluntary partnership with a number of organizations, other federal agencies, industry, academia, and scientific societies. And it's an opportunity to recognize outstanding innovations that prevent pollution at the source. We receive nominations, and they're judged by a panel of technical experts convened by the American Chemical Society. And typically five awards are given to industry, to a small business, and to an academic investigator.
Are there any fruits of our labor? For instance, are there results from our hard work?
In fact, there are, and the results are impressive. Through 2009, in the 14 years of the challenge, the award-winning technologies are preventing 193 million pounds, the user generation of 193 million pounds of hazardous substances. That's enough to fill 900 railroad tank cars or train 11 miles long. In addition, award-winning technologies are saving 21 billion gallons of water, or enough for a city of 820,000 people. Also, there's 57 million pounds of CO2 emissions are prevented, which is roughly the equivalent of taking 6,000 cars off the road. And that's on top of the tens of millions of dollars that the companies and their customers are saving. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. All the nominated technologies, when you add up the benefits of all the nominated technologies, it's very much more.
Wow, that's impressive and both beneficial for our environment and for people. Rich, can you give us some examples of green chemistry in the lives of people like you and I?
Sure. Let's take paint. We're all familiar with that new paint smell when you go into a freshly painted room. That odor is the result of volatile organic compounds that are added to the paint. And there are paints right now on the market that have essentially no volatile component. And in 2005, we gave an award to a bio-based additive for water-based latex paints. These paints have better scrub resistance, better opacity, and essentially no odor. In 2009, this year, we're giving an award for a breakthrough for oil-based paints. Another example is carpet tile. This is carpet that you might typically find in an office or a commercial setting. We gave an award in 2003 to a carpet tile that's made from less hazardous substances and is completely recyclable. And this is also commercially available right now. And these are just two of the many, many examples that we have on our website.
Thank you for being here today, Rich.
It's been a real pleasure. Thank you very much.
For more information on the 2009 Presidential Green Chemistry Challenge Award winners and EPA's Green Chemistry Program, visit www.epa.gov/greenchemistry. See you next time on Green Scene.